Only one person at a time is allowed to enter the space. Once inside, the spectator finds in front of him a big construction that looks like the corner, the joint point of two walls. Going around it becomes clear that the construction is not a square or a box, but actually an L shape. On the other side of the joint, there is a man. He is trying with extreme concentration and patience to build houses made from cards. The presence of the public irritates him. The audience thinks that the man with the cards is the actual performance piece. But suddenly, thanks to a specific lighting, the spectator starts to wonder that it's actually possible to enter this L shape and discovers inside it a corridor space. The walk in the corridor is difficult by its internal construction. Walking till the end of the corridor, the audience is confronted with a dead hand, a black wall. Disappointed, the spectator is ready to walk back. At the very moment he's turning his back, he suddenly hears a firm and secure voice asking, "What do you want?" Looking back again, he suddenly finds in front of him, behind the red rope, a child, a very young, beautiful girl, looking at him. The spectator starts to talk with the girl, but she will always reply with the same sentence, "What do you want?" In this kind of performance piece, it's always very difficult to summarize or describe what happened with the audience. Every single person experienced the piece in a very personal way.
It's guilty.
I want love.
What do you want?
One day to have kids.
What do you want?
Nice weather.
What do you want?
To be happy.
What do you want?
A dog.
What do you want?
I think that's it.
What do you want?
The first impact of most of the audience, when ready to leave the corridor and suddenly hear the voice and discover the child, is of course of great shock and big surprise. After the first seconds of surprise and fear, every person has a very personal interaction. Many answer the girl and they ask how to go out, as if they forgot the way back. And others start to talk in a very intimate way, really trying to respond to the actual question, "What do I want?" Many describe this piece as a kind of sublime experience. You find yourself in a very strong confrontation next to the beauty and the innocence of the child. The cold indifference of the young girl to whatever the spectator will say to her, together with her secure and firm voice, continuously repeating the same sentence, or just looking and waiting, is a very sharp contrast to her nice and fragile presence. Only if the spectator will answer to the question, "What do you want?" "Nothing." Then she will respond, "Okay." Then you get nothing. And the girl will close again the black curtain and disappear. In all the other cases, she will just go on and repeat, "What do you want?"